Hello everyone, and let's check out another exciting chess game from the history of chess. And in this chess game, white is Bobby Fischer, and his opponent is Oyar Sili. This game was played in 1964 in the United States. Let's check out how this game went on. Bobby Fischer starts the game with playing e4, e5, knight to f3, knight to c6, bishop to c4. The Italian opening, after bishop to c4, here comes bishop to c5. And the Evans Gambit, Bobby Fischer, is playing the old school opening. The Evans Gambit is following his predecessors. After b4, we have bishop takes on b4, accepting, and then c3, bishop to e7, and attacking the center, d4, d6. Exchanging the pawns, capturing back with the knight. Bobby Fischer captured back, and then Bobby Fischer captured the knight. Knight takes on e5. D takes on e5. What would you do in this position? Well, Bobby Fischer is attacking the king. How to defend? g6. This time, the e-pawn is falling. Bobby Fischer captured the pawn. Queen takes on e5. Also attacking the rook. How to defend? Developing the knight and blocking the rook. Fischer played bishop to a3. The bishop is pinned. And black can't castle. Rook to f8. Black's pieces has been paralyzed. The king is stuck on e8. And this is a clunky position. After rook to f8, Bobby Fischer happily castled. And Fischer has the comfortable, the flexible position. Knight to g4. Attacking the queen. Queen to g3. Bishop takes on a3. Knight takes on a3. Queen to e7. And bishop to b5. By Bobby Fischer. Which looks like a blunder, because black played c6. Attacking the bishop and the knight at the same time. If defending the bishop, then queen takes on a3. Fischer played knight to c4. We have queen to e6. If capturing the bishop, then here comes knight to d6. This is check. Moving the king. Knight takes on c8. Rook takes on c8. And queen takes on g4. Let's get back to the real game. So after c6, Fischer played knight to c4. Queen to e6. And then Fischer played rook from a to d1. C takes on b5, and here comes queen to c7, threatening checkmate. Rook to d8 is the threat. How to defend? Defending with the bishop, and Fischer played the obvious move. He played knight to d6. This is check. As you can see, the king's safety has been compromised. But at the same time, Bobby Fischer is a piece down. With this aggressive chess game, with this aggressive style, he sacrificed a piece. That was a part of a plan. After checking the king, we have king to e7. And can you guess the killer attack, the crushing attack in this position? What would you do? Well, Bobby Fischer played. Are you ready? Knight to f5, sacrificing the second piece by Fischer. And Sili captured the knight. G takes on f5. And then E takes on f5. The deadly e-file is open. Fischer plays like Michael Tell. Or maybe he is playing like Paul Morphy. He also starts the game with playing the Evans Gambit. Just like Paul Morphy would. The e-file is open. Fischer is waiting and he is seeking for the perfect moment to strike. And when he did that, that is not going to be pretty. After e takes on f5, we have rook from a to c8, attacking the queen. The queen is under attack. Well, Bobby Fischer didn't move the queen. He moved the rook. He played rook takes on d7. Another smashing attacking move by Fischer. Ignoring the attack, he is attacking himself. What else? Sili captured the rook. Queen takes on d7. And then f6, check. Knight takes on f6. Of course, if capturing with the king, then capturing the queen. After knight takes on f6, Fischer. Fischer played the obvious move. And what is the obvious move in this position? Fischer played rook to e1. This is check. After defend. The only defense. Blocking with the knight. Knight to e4. The only move. And then Bobby Fischer captured the knight. Rook takes on e4. Moving the king. What else? The only move. And then Bobby Fischer captured the queen. Queen takes on d7. Attacking the queen. A funny move. Silly is trying the last trick. If playing a ridiculous move, like capturing the pawn, capturing the b-pawn, there is back rank mate. With rook to d1. But Bobby Fischer was not a chess betzer, nor a fool. So Fischer played queen to g4. Defending the queen, and also defending the back rank threat. Defending with the queen, as you can see. There is no checkmate, and Bobby Fischer has the extra queen. Well, simply, after queen to g4, Boyard Sili resigned. He has no chance against Bobby Fischer after this position. This endgame is basically a rook against a queen endgame. And this is losing for Sili. And thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Take care, and bye-bye.